I'm Ilyan St-Hilaire, and in this video, we're going to take a look at MeshCentral support for sharing a web relay. MeshCentral has had the ability to share desktop files and remote terminal to a guest, and that guest doesn't have to have an account on MeshCentral. You can create a URI link that is time limited, and so you control when it turns on, when it turns when it's no longer valid, and you can expire it anytime you want. And you take that link, you give it to your friend, and they can access that remote device. So I have a video on that already. In this video, I'm going to show how we've increased or improved that feature by also allowing you to share a private website with somebody, and they can access that private website even though the website is in a private network and there is no VPN. So we're going to take a look at doing that. So basically sharing a web relay to a guest. So first of all, I'm going to take a look at a couple slides. Just a quick introduction as to what MeshCentral is here is capable of doing. For a long time, you can use MeshCentral router, and you can port map a TCP port from MeshCentral router to a remote website as long as there's an agent on the network. Then on the remote network, then you can access this private website through a tunnel created by MeshCentral router and the MeshCentral server and the agent. Okay, so all this is encrypted, and then your traffic from the browser, kind of pops out at the agent. So the agent kind of pretends to be your browser, and then when the web server responds, it goes to your browser. So this is nice. It allows you to access websites on private networks with no VPN. So there's been an improvement to that, which is on top of MeshCentral router, which is web relay. And basically, you can configure MeshCentral to act as a not only as a web server for itself, but as a web server for a relay to a remote website. So in that case, you would browse to MeshCentral on a special port or a special DNS name, and then MeshCentral would tunnel that connection to an agent, ask the web server what's going on, ask the request, get the answer back, and serve it to your browser. So that's web relay. And web relay can work by adding a relay port. So for example, you would have HTTPS 443, which is the normal HTTPS for MeshCentral, but you can have another different port. For example, here 453, it would be configured as the relay port. And so MeshCentral would set up a special HTTPS server, but only for the purpose of relaying traffic to other websites through agents. So that's one way to configure it. And of course, once you have that set up, then you see the HTTP and HTTPS links on devices, and you can click on those and see the web page on those devices. So the same can be set up, and I won't go through too much detail here, but you can also set up the same thing with DNS names. So in this case, you only have port 443, you still have the same port for MeshCentral, but you point multiple DNS names like Relay 1, Relay 2, Relay 3 to MeshCentral. And then basically, if MeshCentral is being accessed through one of these DNS names, then MeshCentral will serve as a relay to the remote website. Okay. And quickly, how this works is that if you have a relay port or a relay DNS, MeshCentral will send a cookie to your browser. And every time your browser hits that relay port or that relay DNS, then MeshCentral will know what you're actually trying to do and forward the traffic to the private website on the back. Okay, so that's web relay. A separate feature is guest sharing. And guest sharing is when you go onto a device, you click on the share, you click the share button, and you say, I want to share, for example, the desktop or the desktop terminal and files, and you say for how long and what the conditions are, And it will create a URI that you can give to somebody, and anybody can just access that URI and access the file or the terminal or the desktop of that remote computer. So this is super useful because, you know, let's suppose you want to give a friend access to a machine for 15 minutes. You can do it without them having an account, without them signing up for anything. You just get the URI in an email, you click on it, and it just gives you access immediately. I wouldn't recommend sharing the URI through an email, though. The best is to use, if you're going to create your links to share stuff like that, you probably want to use some kind of secure way to send that link to your friend, to try a Signal Messenger or something like that. That would be the ideal. Okay, so we talked about the web relay, which is the ability to see web pages on private networks through MeshCentral. And we talked about guest sharing, which is the ability for users to access remote devices. So what we're going to talk about in this video is the fusion or the merging of these two solutions together, or these two different features together. So you can now share an HTTP or HTTPS website on a device. So now you can click on the share button, the same share button that you use to create a guest share for desktop, terminal, and files. But now you can select as type, you can select HTTP or HTTPS, you can set the port, put a guest name as you would for any guest sharing, and click OK, and it will create you a link, but that link, when accessed, accesses this website through MeshCentral and through the remote agent. Okay, so hopefully that was clear. If not, let's go and try to do a demo of this. So first of all, demo setup. This is my trusty developer server, and this is the MeshCentral web page. And so, of course, we have a bunch of machines and everything works as one would expect. Now, I've already set up web relay with this machine, with MeshCentral here. So if you click on, you'll see that the HTTP and the HTTPS links are there at the bottom of the devices page. If you don't see the HTTP and the HTTPS links here, it's because you have not set up web relay. You need to set up an extra port or extra DNS in order for web relay to work. Okay, so I have a machine here called AMT15, and on this machine, I am going to set up a little website. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna switch over here and to my AMT15 machine. So this is my remote machine on a private network. And what I did is I'm running mesh command space mesh commander. And this creates a little website on port 3000 where it runs mesh commander, the website, and you can manage AMT machines. It doesn't matter for this purpose, any website will do, but here I happen to have a website on port 3000. I'm going to open a browser, and just to demonstrate accessing that site, I'm going to say localhost port 3000, enter. Oops, sorry. I need to not search that. I need to actually access it, HTTP localhost 3000, enter. There you go. And we see the Mesh Commander website. Now, again, it could be any website. I'm just using this one as demonstration. By the way, here, Mesh Command will only allow you to access the website through the loopback interface. So this website is not even available on a private network. It's available only on that, that remote machine. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I want to have somebody outside on the internet get access to this website here on my machine. And this website is not even available to my private network. It's just locally available. But of course, I'm running a mesh agent on this device. So this is what we're going to do is we are going to, if I come back here, what we're going to do is have, we're going to create a link that goes through MeshCentral, through the agent, and then this is going to use the loopback interface to access this Mesh Commander web server. Okay, and by the way, this is on port 3000. Okay, So just to prove that Web Relay works, I've already set up here. By the way, if you see HTTP or HTTPS, you can right-click and say alternate port. And by default, it'll just say HTTP or HTTPS right there. But I don't have a website on port 80. I have a website on port 3000. So you right-click alternate port. You write 3000. Okay. And then when I click on it, you'll notice I have a DNS web relay. So it says relay one, da-da-da-da-da, and I'm accessing that private website. And I can do stuff on it. Okay, so I can use the web relay, access the website, but of course, in order to get access to these links, I need to be logged in with sufficient rights inside MeshCentral to access these links. But I'm gonna click the share button, and now in type, normally I can share the desktop, share desktop view only, terminal files, but there's HTTP here. So I'm gonna click HTTP, I'm gonna say port 3000, the guest, I'm gonna call it Bob, and starting now, and let's say for 30 minutes. So, starting now for 30 minutes, create me a link that accesses the HTTP port 3000 on this machine, and call the link Bob. And so I'm gonna say okay. And now it's gonna create the link, and it's gonna tell me the start and expire time. So 30 minutes in this case, between these two times. By the way, all these times on MeshCentral, they are always sent in UTC to the browser, and the browser converts them to your local time. So these times will all be, if somebody else in another time zone looks at these times, they will be corrected for their local time. Okay, so it created me this link. I can copy the link to the clipboard by clicking this little link, or I can just open it and I have access to the website there. Also, I can click OK. And the reason I can click OK and dismiss this is because, I'm gonna delete this old one link, but you can see here, active device sharing, Bob, HTTP 3000, and then the time interval. So this is the time, and no consent is needed. And then there's a little garbage can here. If you trash this link, then it will immediately not be available anymore. So users you gave that link to will no longer be able to use it. And there's a little device sharing link here. You can click on it to bring you to this link. Okay. So just to prove to you that this is this link that I just copied is available or accessible from anywhere, I can copy this link, and I'm going to open up Chrome here. And Chrome, this browser is not logged into MeshCentral. So if I go to my MeshCentral server and say proceed, I am currently logged in as. I have this debug option that says always log me in. So I want to get rid of that. So I'm going to log out. Okay, so I'm logged in on Firefox. I'm not logged in on Chrome, but I am going to paste this link, say enter, and then I'm accessing the private website. And as I'm accessing this private website, you'll notice on the right here, there's a little blue icon, and it says that, that I am currently routing one session. So this link that you send, whenever somebody uses it, it's going to show up as the user that created the link. So because this is my name and I'm the one who created that link, then anybody publicly accessing that link, it will look like it's for me. Okay, Chrome here did not have to log in to MeshCentral in order to access that share. And yeah, now I can do WebSocket. I can, basically access this website completely from outside. And you notice that it says not secure here because I don't have Let's Encrypt certificate for my, test server. But you'll notice that this is, even if the form website, the private website is HTTP, you'll notice that this is always HTTPS. All the links that MeshCentral will give you is always a GPS, and you'll have full encryption from the browser to MeshCentral, and then MeshCentral will grab your request, proxy them over to the agent. The connection between the agent and MeshCentral is also encrypted. And then the agent to the final destination, that is not necessarily encrypted. It depends. It depends if you're accessing HTTP or GPS. Okay, hopefully that was clear. Hopefully that was useful. Basically, allowing people, I don't know how many other products can do this, but basically allowing people on the internet to get access to a private website on your network and doing it entirely with them not having any sign-in, not creating any account on MeshCentral. Fairly powerful stuff. Hopefully you like that. Thank you very much. Have a great day.